a Networking Arizona moment with Carol Blonder.
A lot of people, they put their head in the sands when it comes to estate planning. I have with me Stephanie Maloney, and she's the owner of Premier Estate Planning. Stephanie, is estate planning, how important is it, and is it all about money or what?
No, Carol, I feel estate planning really has not much to do with money. It's about having control of decisions, either healthcare or financial decisions, because you put documents in place to give someone else permission to do things on your behalf, either because you become incapacitated or you're gone. So that is the purpose of the documents. It doesn't matter if you're an 18-year-old college student away at school, you can have an accident, and now your parents need documents to be able to make decisions for you. So it's really not about money at all.
So who should consider then having an estate plan?
Well, everyone should consider getting a consultation so they can learn about what estate planning is. I've always joked that estate planning education is done by movies and television, and it's always negative. You hear about somebody not happy about the trust they were left, or the trouble with the will. That's where people are getting their information, or they're trying to Google and figure it out on their own, which that just, it's information overload, and then you really don't know, and you get analysis paralysis, because then you don't know what to ask, and you don't want to feel silly. And everybody just needs to relax, get their education, and ask their questions, because it's your first time. If I were going to try to jump in and do your job, I wouldn't know what I was doing. So,
well, you do free consultations with
yes.
people. You also work nationwide. Her phone number to call is 602-371-8898. The website is Premier Arizona, so it's premieraz.net. I'm going away from those questions for a second, because I want to ask you, when you work with people, I know that you say that you like to really educate them and follow them along through the entire process. And afterwards.
Yes, I call it, you know, it's hand-holding, whether it's mental or literally hand-holding to get them, to get everything done. But from the first phone call through the consultation, sitting, we always allow at least 2 hours for a consultation, because when you start talking about this, then it brings up other questions you hadn't even considered. So you have your consultation, and then once people have the education, then they can choose the documents that are right for them, because it's not a one size fits all.
What are the ramifications for people that do try and do it on their own?
That you might do it wrong, you know? And I think that all of these services that are out there, such as a LegalZoom, the legal profession as a whole doesn't mind them, because they're not competition. They create a lot of problems that they're going to be able to fix. So it's not a problem for the industry. It's not competition for a law firm. It's ultimately, could it result in problems? Because I do document reviews, and I see it all the time where things just weren't done properly. And it's because you don't know when you're going through the process, and I've even tried it myself just to see what clients would experience. And I'm in the business, and it's confusing.
Well, talk about something that really quickly before we leave on to the next question is that what a document preparer does, because you do things a little different than other people.
Yeah, well, we're a family business, so when I meet people, I'm gonna have a relationship if they become my client until they're gone or I'm gone. That's the way I look at a relationship. And we take them in and we really make sure they're gonna understand. When we do a document delivery, it's a 2-hour process. They're not just coming in and signing. I mean, I've had people say, you know, can't we just do this DocuSign, or can I sign for my husband? I've been doing it for 20 years. No, you can't. You have to sit down, take the time, and after a delivery, which is 2 hours, it's really overwhelming. And then I give the people a couple days, and I said, then we're gonna touch base again. Now we're gonna talk about the next steps, because it doesn't just stop at the signing. There's work that you have to do, but you're not digging ditches. It's a little paperwork to get your life in order, and then it's done. And I have a process called successor education. So when everything is done and they've chosen their documents, whatever they are, I'm going to offer to talk to their people that they're naming that are coming after them when they can't make decisions, so that they know what they're supposed to do. They get a little dry run. And I hope, you know, if I'm working with a family that's in their 40s, I hope it's a long time before these documents are gonna be needed. But their person or their people that they're choosing, they'll have some memory of some of it. It won't be a complete, you know, just, I don't know what to do, hopefully. And they know where to call.
More than anything, peace of mind.
Yes.
Peace of mind. So do you do second opinions?
Yes, we do document reviews all the time. And, you know, it's a good idea. I've even had my own documents reviewed after we've done them. People want to make sure we're doing good work.
dust them off and take them out. Give her a call. Listen, this is something that's serious and for everyone to do. The number to call is 602-371-8898. It's premierAZ.net.